Good morning. It is November 11th, and I find myself in a tree stand with a buck tag in my pocket. The last time I left you guys, I talked about late December being the next time I was going to have the chance to get out for Iowa's late muzzleloader season. And I find myself on my first out-of-state hunt in the state of Illinois. Very, very fortunate to have a good friend in Kane Gillette who invited us down to hunt this week. And it's been an action-packed morning so far. I think we've seen two small bucks, this button buck. He's actually out in the field right now. And then we saw a doe probably 10 minutes ago. It's been really hot for most of November. You know, when Hunter and I left Iowa yesterday, it was somewhere in the 50s. Got to Illinois, it was mid-70s. And then now we're sitting in the high 30s, low 40s. I'm not sure exactly what, but for anybody who's in the stand today in the Midwest, you know that big weather front went through yesterday. Deer are on their feet, and we're hoping to catch a buck in between does cruising through these bedding areas. From my understanding, and what we can see movement-wise, we've got bucks working across from in front of us and then off to our left, so. Brad and Kane are also out on the farm right now. They're hunting on the west side of the farm. And I also got a text from one of my really good buddies back home, Wayne. Shot a great buck, so shout out to you, buddy. Congrats, you and put your dime in. So hopefully we can join the club and at least get a sighting on one of these good bucks that Kane's got on the farm. Either way, all I know is that I'm very excited to be back in the stand with a bow in hand. And Hunter and I are going to have ourselves a fun week.
$100 there or something behind you. I don't know, she hasn't looked back one time, you know what I mean?
She's looking now. Yo, buck.
Yeah, pretty decent buck, you know. Pretty good, eh, boy?
About 9:15 here
and we're gonna wrap up this morning's hunt. Overall, very good movement. Ended up seeing 7 bucks, 2 does and 2 fawns, so plenty of action. Just no mature bucks, no target bucks. And anxious to hear what Kane and Brad saw. It was a beautiful morning, and the weather's setting up to be pretty good for the next couple of days, so we're gonna do our best to take advantage of it, go back, get some food, regroup, and try to get out of the stand early as possible at night. The afternoon of November 11th, and Hunter and I are set up for the evening hunt. It's gonna end up being a pretty quick one. It's about 3:30 right now. We came in and did a hanging hunt on this flat. Essentially, what our thought process of coming here was that we didn't want to hunt anything that was open, food source, food plot type area, because we figured those does are gonna be hanging off the edges of that. And I believe to our west, there's a little bit of a food source. Out to our east, there's a cut ag field, and right now, like I mentioned, we're just on this big ridge of bedding, so hoping to either catch a buck in between does, a buck on a doe, and maybe even give calling a go. It's a risky spot to do that, and I really should have set up closer to that cut field, just because if we do call, I have a feeling we're going to be able to get downwind of us, but depending on the situation, we'll see what happens. There's a really good deer in here that Kane calls Big Show. He's a big wide, I believe a 9-pointer with a split brow. And that's really the target deer we're in here after, so. I think we got in here pretty clean from what I expected, so. We'll sit back and enjoy the night, and hopefully the move pays off. It's about 4:45, guys, and Hunter and I have just over 20 minutes left probably of camera light. We've had a pretty good hunt. We've seen quite a few deer, a couple deer out in this pick field that I mentioned out to our east, and then we saw a little bit of a chase about 5 minutes ago, ended up being 2 spikes and on a doe. And Hunter and I were just in the tree talking about how, regardless of it not being a bigger deer, it's still awesome to see it every time you get the chance. And despite the fact that we never saw a shooter today, from what I've heard, a lot of guys gotten in some really good deer today. I know Caleb Mason put a buck on the ground, and that means that Team Tatey and Mason is done for the bow season in Iowa. Can't wait to see that story. And then I believe that Jared encountered Marino today. And finally, Kane and Brad, I think, were on a good buck tonight. So, you know, like I said, even though we didn't get the chance to see a good deer, it's awesome to know that the team was into a lot of good action. And Hunter and I are excited to spend the rest of this week putting in our time and hopefully get an opportunity. So, like I mentioned, still got about 15, 20 minutes left. Could happen. Probably not, but we're going to sit it out till the end, and we'll see you guys in the tree tomorrow morning.